Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and many of you have been asking for tips for the Apple Watch, and hopefully I've found 10 of them that you may not know. So the first one has to do with finding your iPhone if you lose it. This one you're probably familiar with, but if you swipe up from the bottom on your Apple Watch, you've got your different options here in your control center. Tap on your phone icon, and it will immediately ping your phone and help you try and locate it within your house or wherever you might have misplaced it. Now the next thing has to do, again with a control center feature, swipe up from the bottom, go to Do Not Disturb, turn it on, and now you have another option if you scroll down that says Leave It On Until I Leave, and this can be where you're currently located. So in my case, it's my home. When I leave my home, it will turn off. Or maybe you're in a movie theater or at some presentation and you don't want it to be on the whole time, but you want to remember to turn it back on so that you get your notifications. This will turn this feature off as soon as you leave that area. So we'll turn it back off for now. Now the next thing is you can take a screenshot on your Apple Watch. You may or may not know that, but it's not turned on by default. It's similar to the iPhone. Push both buttons at once and it saves to your photos on your iPhone. However, it's not turned on by default, so you'll need to turn that on in the Watch app. So let's go to Watch and then we go to General. Scroll down and you'll see there's enable screenshot. So make sure that's turned on and then you'll be able to screenshot on your watch. Now the next tip has to do with using the flashlight on your watch. You may have seen the flashlight icon here. If you tap it, you've got a white display. If you swipe to the right though, you've got a blinking display, or even again, you've got a red display, and this helps you not illuminate the room as brightly when you need to use this as a flashlight. So it's one way to kind of dim the display without actually dimming it, and it should help if you're using it as a flashlight. Now, the next thing has to do with illuminating your display. Now, maybe you've got a notification on your wrist and you just want to peek at it, but you don't want to turn your wrist to turn it on. You can move the digital crown slightly and bring the screen brightness up. Check your watch, bring it back down. Now, you can go all the way up, and if you have a Series 4 Apple Watch, you can kind of feel the detents until it stops. When they stop, it means it's full bright. You can't go back. Turn it back off, rotate it up again, and it starts to brighten the display or the screen so that you can see it. So it's a handy little tip if you just need to check it subtly if you can. Now the next thing has to do with your applications. So you'll see here's your apps and this is the default layout. Now we can change this and I'll show you that in a moment, but maybe you just want to know what they are alphabetically. You can force press, tap list view, and now you have all of your apps alphabetically. So it makes it a little bit easier instead of using that grid. If we go back to the grid view and we prefer this view, we can organize those on our iPhone. So we'll go back to the iPhone, go back to the Watch app. And if we go down to our app layout here, go to app layout and you'll see there's the current app layout. If I tap and hold, maybe I want music over here on the right instead of mail. And I want home in place of mail. You'll see we've got music and mail. And then maybe I want to move the calendar over here. You'll see I can move those around however I would like, and they change instantly on your watch. So if I go back to the watch, you'll see they're already changed. So music is where I put it. Also, the home app is where I put it. So it's a simple way to organize your apps if it's driving you nuts and you're not able to find them easily. Now, the next thing has to do with messages. If we go into messages, you'll see I have my current location sent to, this is actually my brother. So if you want to do that, you just force press the display and tap on send location, and it will send them your location. It takes a moment, it sends, and then it confirms it by saying it's delivered right there. So it takes a moment. And if they have an iPhone, you'll get the delivered receipt. So that's a simple tip in case you're in trouble or you just want to meet up and tell them where you're at. Now, the next thing again has to do with messages. You've got all of these replies here. So you've got your quick replies, and maybe you want to put something that's just not here, BRB, or maybe you don't like to use that and you want to say be right back. You can do that in the app on the iPhone. So if we go back to my watch, we'll go to messages. Then we scroll down to default replies. Under default replies, we have smart replies. Now we can just scroll to the bottom, click add reply, and say be right back. And then go back and it will be there. So again, smart replies, be right back is still there. Now it should be on the Apple Watch. Be right back is there. Now, one thing you may have noticed is that my text is larger than the default setting and it's bolded. And this is an option in the Apple Watch app on your phone. So if you go back to your phone, go to the Watch app, and then scroll down until you get to brightness and text size. And you'll see my text is all the way up. You can move this down, turn off bold text, but to do that, you have to restart. So you have these options and it works really well. If you're having a hard time seeing it, or maybe you just want the text larger, it's an easy way to do that. The next thing also has to do with haptic feedback on your watch. Similarly to the bold text, this will help you feel the watch vibrate a little bit more prominently. And that's this default or prominent under the haptic feedback alerts. So what that means is when it vibrates, you'll hear it ding there. Not only will it be a little bit louder based on this, but it will also vibrate depending on how much you've set this to. So maybe you're getting directions, you have a hard time feeling that, turn that to prominent and you'll feel that a little bit stronger. So those are 10 tips that hopefully you didn't know all of. Let me know if you knew them all or didn't know them all in the comments below. And of course, I'll link the wallpaper in the description. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.